먼저 양 정상의 모두 발언을 듣고 질의응답 순서로 진행하겠습니다. 모두 발언은 문재인 대통령과 트럼프 대통령 순으로 진행하겠습니다. 먼저 대한민국 문재인 대통령의 모두 발언을 듣겠습니다.
도널드 트럼프 대통령님의 대한민국 방문을 진심으로 환영합니다. 오늘 한반도는
The United States and North Korea will be meeting in Panmunjom. For the first time in history, the leaders of the United States and North Korea will be standing face to face in Panmunjom, the symbol of division, and make handshakes for peace. If we continue to communicate and engage each other in dialogue, we can move towards the best situation. This is something that we'll be able to see for ourselves today. South and North will be able to become confident about peace, and the world will provide their support and cheer on President Trump and Chairman Kim with high expectations. What we need here is enduring peace on the Korean Peninsula. I hope that President Trump will go down in history as a president that has achieved peace on the Korean Peninsula. Peace requires more courage than conflict. I would like to extend my appreciation to the two leaders for being so brave, and I am very overwhelmed with emotions because we have been able to prove the way towards peace for the Korean Peninsula. Continuous dialogue is the only viable option for achieving complete denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula. Today, President Trump and I have reaffirmed that we're absolutely on the same page when it comes to denuclearization and that we share common goals. In particular, as complete denuclearization and peace building on the Korean Peninsula and normalization of US-DPRK relations were the goals committed to in the Singapore Agreement, we concurred that implementing this agreement simultaneously and in parallel would be vitally important. To that end, I hope that dialogue between the US and DPRK will resume as early as possible. And I hope that there will be a progress made between the leaders of the two countries together with the people of the Republic of Korea. And not only the security for the ROC-US alliance has become a comprehensive strategic alliance that strengthens cooperation in not only security but also economic region and global issues. Such steadfast ROC-US alliance is working as the linchpin for regional peace, stability, and prosperity, and we have decided to continue in close coordination.
As President Trump has said, I believe that this is a victory for both countries as we have established an institutional framework with the CORUS FTA amendment. Today, our two leaders have agreed to further accelerate the momentum to expand trade and investment and further expand the CORUS alliance to a mutually reciprocal economic alliance as well. In regional and global issues as well, our two countries will continue to work very closely together as strong allies. The Asia-Pacific region is a core region for peace and prosperity for both countries. Under the regional cooperation principles of openness, inclusiveness, and transparency, I believe that Korea's new southern policy and the U.S. Indo-Pacific strategy can find common ground. Recently, we have shared in our concerns related to the attack on the oil tankers in the Gulf of Oman and the escalation of tension in the Middle East. Freedom of passage and freedom of transit in the Gulf of Oman is very important for the stability of the Middle East and security of international energy. I have a high regard for the careful restraint showed by President Trump. We have agreed to closely cooperate for stability in the Middle East. President Trump and I will not forget the history and the spirit of a great alliance. Our two countries will work very closely in cooperation as strong allies. With this visit to the Republic of Korea, we have once again reaffirmed our common objectives and strategies, and I'm very glad and heartened by this. Going forward, we will continue to work very closely together and be frank and open in our discussions and communications to strongly solidify and develop the ROK-US alliance. President Trump is the maker of peace on the Korean Peninsula. You really are the peacemaker of the Korean Peninsula. I hope that this meeting with Chairman Kim Jong-un at the Panmunjom will bring hope to the people of South and North Korea, and that it will be a milestone in the history of humankind towards peace. Again, I would like to extend my warmest welcome to President Trump to Korea. Our friendship will continue to grow deeper and greener as the leaves of early summer. Thank you.
감사합니다. 다음은 미합중국 트럼프 대통령의 모두 발언 듣겠습니다.
Thank you very much. I'm just going to make a very short statement because we're going to the DMZ border and I'll be meeting with Chairman Kim. I look forward to it very much. I look forward to seeing him. We've developed a very good relationship and we understand each other. I do believe he understands me and I think I maybe understand him. And sometimes that can lead to very good things. I want to start by just thanking President Moon and, very importantly, First Lady Moon, who's a very special woman, very special spirit. She loves your country very much, as does President Moon. And we had a great dinner last night together and spent a large part of the morning discussing lots of different things, including trade and military, frankly, and many other items. But I thought I would just mention that when we came here, our great ambassador, we arrived last night, our great ambassador, who's here someplace, Harry, was talking about the turmoil going on because of the level of, there was the vitriol, the level of vitriol that was happening between North and South, but it was North to a large extent where there was a lot of risk and a lot of threat and a lot of bad things were happening. That was before I became president. And as you know, and the media knows very well, because they covered it, frankly, very well and very fairly, at the beginning there was a lot of anger between myself and Kim Jong-un, who since something happened. There was a point at which it happened, and all of a sudden, we get along. And I figured that when I was in Japan, where they hosted a fantastic G20, and I want to just thank Prime Minister Abe, because they did a fantastic job, and a lot of good things came out of that, a lot of good meetings with other countries, I can tell you from the standpoint of the United States. But we decided to come here a while ago as part of going to the G20, I promised President Moon. And then yesterday I was just thinking, hey, I'm here. Let's see whether or not we can say hello to Kim Jong-un. And I put out the word and he got back. And he wanted to do it from the beginning and so did I. But there's a lot of good feeling, you know, when sometimes the media will say, gee, what's happened? Well, they know what's happened. What's happened is there was nuclear testing. There was ballistic missile testing. They had hostages of ours, as you know, a very tough situation. And now we're getting back our remains. We got back the hostages. There's been no ballistic missile tests, and there's been no nuclear tests. And South Korea is a whole different place. And Japan, Prime Minister Abe was telling me, Japan is a whole different place. They had missiles going over Japan on a very constant basis. You know that very well. So I hate to hear the media, you know, give false information to the public when they say, oh, what's been done? What's been done? A lot's been done. And there's also a good feeling. I can tell you on behalf of President Moon, he feels much better about even Chairman Kim. I mean, he feels much better. They couldn't have meetings. Nobody was going to meet. President Obama wanted to meet. And Chairman Kim would not meet him. The Obama administration was begging for a meeting. They were begging for meetings constantly. And Chairman Kim would not meet with him. And for some reason, we have a certain chemistry or whatever. Now, let's see what happens. We have a long way to go. But I'm in no rush. The sanctions are on. And I'm in no rush. I'm in no rush with Iran. I'm never in a rush. If you're in a rush, you get yourself in trouble. So I just want to say that we're going to be heading out to the DMZ, and something I planned long ago, but had the idea yesterday to maybe say hello and just shake hands quickly and say hello, because we haven't seen each other since Vietnam. We had a great meeting in Vietnam. People don't realize it. It's all part of the whole negotiation. But we had actually a great meeting in Vietnam. We had a great meeting in Singapore. Everyone gave us praise for Singapore and not for Vietnam. I think, frankly, the meeting in Vietnam, in terms of a deal, was more important than Singapore. So I think what I'd like to do is we'll take one or two questions, as I understand it, and then I'm going to head out to the DMZ and pay my respects to everybody, including some soldiers. We have tremendous military here in South Korea, and we're going to see some of our great American soldiers. I'll be talking to them, and I'll be seeing Kim Jong-un. And if you would, you could start with a question. Thank you.
네, 감사합니다.
Thank you very much. 지금부터 기자 여러분들의 질문을 from members of the media. I know this is a very busy time, so we will just take one question each. In terms of the order, the Blue House will first take a question from a reporter, which will be answered by President Moon, followed by the White House. And President Trump will answer that question. The Q&A session will be interpreted consecutively, so please remove your earpieces. We'll now first take a question by the Blue House. CBS, Park Ji-hwan 기자 질문해 주시죠. CBS, Park Ji-hwan, will you please?
네, CBS 박지환입니다. 트럼프 대통령의 두 번째 한국 방문을 진심으로 환영합니다. 문 대통령님께 질문 드리겠습니다. 대통령님께서는 조금 전 오전에 소인수 정상회담에서 나도 DMZ에 동행할 것이다. 하지만 오늘 대화의 중심은 미국과 북한 정상들이라고 말씀하셨고 대화의 진전이 있기를 기대한다고 언급하셨습니다. 그럼 오늘 북미 정상 간 DMZ 접촉이 이루어지면 이것이 향후 비핵화 협상에 어떤 진전을 가져올 것이라고 기대하시는지요? 또 연내 3차 북미 정상회담 개시 가능성을 어느 정도로 보고 계시는지도 궁금하고요. 마지막으로 하나, 최근 대통령님께서는 그 전 세계 통신사들과의 그 서면 인터뷰에서 북한이 영변 핵시설을 완전한 검증 하에 폐기한다면 국제사회도 일부 제재 완화 조치를 모색할 것이라고 언급하셨는데 오늘 트럼프 대통령과의 그 정상회담에서 그 부분이 논의가 됐는지 미국 측의 반응은 어떠한지 궁금합니다.
Hello, Mr. President. I am Park from CBS, and I'd like to first of all welcome President Trump upon your second visit to the Republic of Korea. At the restricted bilateral meeting this morning, President Moon, you had mentioned that you will be accompanying President Trump to the DMZ, but the focus of the dialogue that will happen at the DMZ will be between President Trump and Chairman Kim, and you said that you are looking forward to much progress being achieved there. So once the contact is established between President Trump and Chairman Kim at the DMZ, what kind of progress do you expect in the subsequent negotiations? And how about the possibility of a third U.S.-North Korea summit happening before the end of the year? And my third question relates to the written interview that you had given to various agencies recently. And in that interview, you had mentioned that if North Korea, under complete inspection verification from the international community, if North Korea dismantles the nuclear complex in Yongbyon, then the international community could explore the sanctions relief, partial sanctions relief. So has there been any discussions regarding this issue this morning, and what was the response from the U.S. side?
예, 그 저도 오늘 판문점에 초대 받았습니다. 그러나 오늘 이 중심은 북미 간의 대화입니다. 트럼프 대통령님과 북한 김정은 위원장과의 상봉, 그리고 대화, 또 그것이 앞으로 계속된 북미 대화로 이어져 나가는 그 과정으로서 큰 의미가 있다고 생각합니다. 그래서 오늘은 북미 간의 대화에 집중하도록 하고 남북 간의 대화는 다음에 다시 또 도모하게 될 것입니다. 제3차 본격적인 북미 정상회담이 언제 열릴 것인지 여부는 오늘의 상봉과 대화가 어떤 변화를 만들어낼지 그게 달려있다고 생각합니다. 기대를 가지고 이렇게 지켜보기 바랍니다. 그리고 마지막에 질문은 이 영변의 그 핵단지가 진정성 있게 완전하게 폐기가 된다면 그것은 되돌릴 수 없는 북한 실질적인 비핵화의 입구가 될 것이다 라는 판단이었고 그런 조치들이 진정성 있게 실행이 된다면 그때 국제사회는 제재에 대한 완화를 이렇게 논의할 수 있게 될 것이다 라는 그런 상황을 말씀드린 것입니다.
Yes, to answer your question, yes, I have been invited to visit Panmunjom with President Trump this afternoon. However, as I had mentioned, the focus of the dialogue today will be the dialogue between the United States and North Korea. And of course, President Trump and Chairman Kim will have a reunion and have subsequent dialogue. And I hope that, and I do believe that this is vastly significant for the dialogue that will follow after the meeting today. And also, today, there will be a dialogue between the United States and North Korea. But as for the inter-Korean dialogue, this will happen at a later time. As for the question regarding the third U.S.-North Korea summit, I believe that how the reunion and the dialogue and the meeting turns out this afternoon will have a great say on when and whether the U.S.-North Korea summit will happen for the third time. So I do expect some progress there. As for the last question, what I had explained was that if North Korea goes through the dismantlement in a genuine way, dismantlement of the nuclear complex in Yongbyon, then this will mean that we'll be arriving at the entrance of a irreversible substantive denuclearization. So if this indeed is implemented, then the international community will be able to discuss partial sanctions relief. My words were in this context.
감사합니다. 다음은 트럼프 대통령께서 질문을 받으시겠습니다. 백악관 기자 지명은 저와 같은 백악관 대변인이시죠? 스테파니 그리샴 씨께서 해주시겠습니다.
Now we'll take a question for President Trump. Ms. Stephanie Grisham, the White House Press Secretary, will choose who will ask the question.
I'm going to let our president choose. Go ahead, Mr. President.
네, okay. 대통령께서 지명하도록 Thank 하겠습니다.
Thank you. She's learned very well.
네, 굉장히...
Thank you very much, Stephanie. I appreciate it. Just to add one thing to your question from CBS, it's just a step. It might be an important step, and it might not. But what we're doing today is a step, and probably it's a step in the right direction. There's a good feeling, so it could be very good. As far as another meeting, I think let's see what happens today before we start thinking about that. But it could be very, important. Let's see a question.
네, 지금 그 방금 Next 얘기한 time. 것에 하나만 좀 더 추가하도록 Next. 하겠습니다. 지금 그 오늘 걸음이 이것이 긍정적인 방향으로 나갈 수도 있고 아닐 수도 있습니다만은 옳은 방향으로 나가기를 바랍니다. 그리고 내가 지금 그 느낌이 좋습니다. 그래서 추가적인 그런 정상회담이 열리는 이런 여부도 오늘 그 만남을 통해서 더 그 구체적으로 알 수 있을 것 같습니다.
Thank you, Mr. President, and thank you, Mr. President. Margaret Tolliff with Bloomberg News. I hope you'll indulge me since we get one question. I'm going to try to make it count. Why do you want to step into North Korea, and what do you think that handshake could actually accomplish? Nothing has substantively changed since Hanoi. North Korea has tested short-range missiles. Why does Kim Jong-un deserve this moment? And how do you respond to the critics who say it's nothing more than a photo op or that you're legitimizing a nuclear state? I also quickly need to get in one China clarification, which is your agreement with President Xi as of yesterday. Does that bring you back to the point in April where they had made a lot of concessions on IP and that sort of stuff? Or are you back at November, back at the beginning of the process?
So and may I, two very distinct questions. Thanks. Hold it before you do
Moon
a third.
Also.
I know, you'll do okay. that in a second.
Thanks.
No, we've made tremendous strides. Only the fake news says that they weren't. If you look again, I don't have to repeat it, but if you look again at where we were 2.5 years ago and I think I can say the hatred that everybody had for everybody and where it was going. And I said that if President Obama's term was for some reason extended through any method, including having a successor that thought the way that that administration thought, you would be right now at war with North Korea. And it wouldn't be pretty, be tough. We have the greatest military in the world by far. We have a much greater military now than we had 2.5 years ago, as you know very well. You reported on it. We bought tremendous equipment from jets to ships to equipment for soldiers. But we are in a much different place right now, Margaret, than we were 2.5 years ago, much different. And the previous administration wanted to talk. I would ask people, why aren't they talking? And not everything happens with talk. Some bad things happen with talk, too. But in this case, we are so far advanced from where we were 2.5 years ago that it's always insulting. And I think it's why the press, frankly, has lost such credibility. They've lost such credibility. But to think that we're comparing where we are now to 2.5 years ago is, in a way, it's insulting. But we're doing well. Let's see what happens in the end. But we're doing well. A big difference. And as far as China is concerned, we are where we are. We're collecting 25% on $250 billion. And China is paying for it, as you know, because, as you notice, our inflation hasn't gone up. China's devalued their currency in order to pay for the tariffs. And in addition to devaluing, they've also pumped a lot of money into their economic model. They've been pumping money, and we haven't. We've been retracting. We've been raising interest rates, and they've been lowering interest rates. So we're not playing on a fair field. The Fed has not been of help to us at all. And despite that, we're winning, and we're winning big, because we have created an economy that is second to none, greatest in the world. And one of the things that happened at the G20, in fact, the president came up and said the same thing to President Moon. Congratulations on the economy. What's happened in the last 2.5 years is incredible. It's incredible. If the other thought process would have won the election, we would have, instead of being up 3%, we would have been down 5%, in my opinion. And I think you would have had a stock market crash because we were heading in that direction. It would have been very, very ugly. Please.
네, 지금 지금 말씀하신 것을 통역하도록 하겠습니다. 그 블룸버그 기자입니다. 질문 하나이기 때문에 좀 길게 하도록 하겠습니다. 왜 그 북한에 가려고 하시는지요? 달성하고자 하는 목적이 무엇입니까? 왜냐하면 예전과 달라진 것은 별로 없는 것 같고 또 북한이 단거리 미사일도 또 발사를 했습니다. 그런데 김정은이 과연 그 트럼프 대통령과의 만남 을 가질 만한 그런 자격이 있는지요. 많은 비판가들은 도리어 이런 만남이 북한을 합법화, 합리화하는 그런 것이 아닌가라고 비판하고 있습니다. 또 시 주석에 대해서 한 가지 또 묻도록 하겠습니다. 시 주석과의 어제 만남을 통해서 지난 4월 다시 말해서 지적재산권을 양보했던 그 단계로 돌아가는 것이 아니냐 아니면은 도리어 11월 그 처음으로 다시 돌아가는 것이 아니냐 어제의 만남을 통해서 그러한 질문들이 나오고 있습니다. 거기에 대해서 지금 트럼프 대통령께서의 답변은 다음과 같습니다. 지난 2년 반 전과 지금을 비교해 본다면 엄청나게 많은 진전을 이룬 것은 사실입니다. 그리고 이런 어디에서 이러한 그 현실과 다른 많은 증거가 있는지 이해하기 힘듭니다. 만일 오바마 행정부가 행정부가 했던 것 그리고 오바마 행정부가 했던 그런 상황으로 나아갔다면 지금 우리는 북한과 전쟁과 분쟁의 그런 상황이 있을 수도 있습니다. 미국은 2년 반 전보다 훨씬 더 강한 군사력을 가지고 있습니다. 여러 가지 그 항공기라든지 장비라든지 또 제트라든지 이런 것들을 많이 확보해서 훨씬 더 강한 그런 군사력을 가지고 있게 되었습니다. 또 그 질문 중에 북한과의 대화를 왜 해야 되느냐라는 질문인데 예전의 그런 시점과 지금의 시점을 비교해 본다면 우린 더 훨씬 더 좋은 그런 자리에 위치해 있는 것이 사실입니다. 그런데 그 언론이 지금 계속 이러한 식으로 나쁜 방향으로 가기 때문에 언론이 믿음을 잃고 있는 것입니다. 물론 오늘 만남을 통해서 어떻게 될지는 우리는 두고 봐야 될 것입니다. 중국에 대해서 또 말씀을 드리자면 중국은 지금 2,500억 중에서 25%를 미국에 관세를 내고 있습니다. 이것은 엄청난 그러한 수입이 미국으로 들어오는 것입니다. 그것을 그 관세 비용을 지불하기 위해서 지금 중국은 화폐 평가 절하를 하고 있습니다. 또 우리는 금리를 인상하는 데 비해서 중국은 지금 금리를 인하하고 있습니다. 그런 면에 있어서 나는 미국 연준이가 하고 있는 행동이 바람직하지 못하다고 생각을 합니다. 시주석도 얘기했고 또 문재인 대통령도 나한테 얘기했습니다만은 지난 2년간 우리가 이루었던 것이 너무나 긍정적이기 때문에 많은 그런 축하를 내가 받고 있습니다. 만일 내가 아닌 다른 사람이 대통령이 됐다면 지금 미국의 상황, 세계의 상황은 훨씬 더 다른 것이 될 것입니다. 증시는 폭락을 했을 것이고 우리는 훨씬 더 안 좋은 그런 위치에 있을 것입니다.
Just to complete, you have to value the stock market from the day after I won. Because there was a tremendous surge after I won, because of the fact I won, because people want that thinking instead of the thinking that we had. If I hadn't won right after the election on November 9th, you would have had a tremendous decrease in the stock market. So I noticed that the previous administrations is given credit for thousands of points of gain right after the election. No, it went up because I won, and we'll take the credit. And if you take that credit, we've increased the stock market values by more than 50%. You have to take that credit. It went up only because I won, and it went up a lot between Election Day and, you know, and when we ultimately took office. And from there, it went up a lot. It continues to go up a lot, and now we're setting records virtually every day. And just to conclude on China, President Xi and I had a fantastic meeting. It's a great meeting. We get along. We also have a really, really good relationship. And he wants to see something happen, and so would I. And I think there's a really good chance of that happening. We had a great meeting. Thank you.
마무리를 하도록 하겠습니다. 내가 아까 그 증시가 상당히 올라갔다라고 얘기를 했는데 내가 당선된 그날도 증시가 상당히 올라갔고 그리고 계속 또 올라가고 있습니다. 만약 내가 당선이 되지 않았다면 증시가 완전히 폭락을 했겠죠. 그리고 이런 여러 가지 경제가 지금 잘 돌아가는 것에 대해서도 이것이 바로 이번 행정부의 공이다라고 말을 해야 되겠습니다. 증시가 점점 더 올라가면서 그 주식의 총액도 지금 수천 퍼센트 더 올라간 것입니다. 내가 당선된 그런 그날에서 행정부가 들어왔을 때까지도 증시가 계속 더 활황이었고 또 행정부 시작에서부터 지금 현재 계속 더 활약이 되고 더 활황이 되고 있습니다. 시주석과의 만남에 대해서 한 말씀 드리자면은 아주 상당히 좋은 그런 그 회담을 했었고 시주석과의 사이도 굉장히 좋습니다. 그 시주석도 뭔가를 해결하고자 하고 나도 해결하고자 하는 그런 의지가 있기 때문에 우리는 앞으로도 잘 해결이 될 것이라고 생각됩니다.
네, 고맙습니다. 네, 지금 이제 시간이 별로 많지가 않습니다. 지금 역사적인 네, 지금 시간이 많지 않아서요.
네, 네, 출발해야 할 시간입니다.
I'm sorry, but we don't have much time. It's time for us to go.
They don't want you to be a mediator in this case. How do you respond? And do you trust President Trump, and if you can take us to the moment when you are at the border, each of you, you are at the demarcation line, what do you believe that stepping over that line may represent for the United States and for the world? Thank you very much.
한 가지 더 그 질문하도록 하겠습니다. So your first question was to President Moon, right? 그 북한 측에서 그 말씀 얘기를 하기를 문 대통령께서 중재자의 역할을 하는 것을 원하지 않는다라고 발표한 바가 있습니다. 거기에 대해서 어떻게 생각하시는지요? 그다음에 두 분 대통령께 질문하고자 하는 것은 오늘 그 비무장지대에서 두 분이 그 걸음을 한 걸음을 해서 그 선을 넘을 건데 그것이 어떤 것을 상징하고 있는지 상징한다고 생각하시는지요?
우선 우리가 대화를 통한 해결 노력을 하지만 모든 일이 한 방향으로만 앞으로 나아가지는 않습니다. 똑바로 나아갈 때도 있지만 구불구불 돌아갈 때도 있고 때로는 멈출 때도 있고 때로는 후퇴할 때도 있는 것입니다. 그러나 대화 외에는 평화를 이룰 방법이 없습니다. 오늘 DMZ 판문점에서의 그 만남은 이 한반도 평화 프로세스에 있어서 아주 역사적인 그런 위대한 순간이 될 것이라고 믿습니다.
First of all, we are indeed striving to achieve peace through a dialogue, but this does not necessarily mean that we will only travel in one direction. Sometimes we'll go straight, but sometimes we'll go through a long and winding road. There comes a time when we have to pause and sometimes we have to retreat. However, it is, I can reassure you that the only way that we can achieve peace is through dialogue. So the meeting this afternoon at Panmunjom will become a truly historic, a great moment in the peace process on the Korean Peninsula.
네, 감사합니다.
Thank you very
Thank
much.
You. Thank you.
네, 그러면 이것으로 대한민국 문재인 대통령과 도널드 트럼프 대통령의 기자회견을 모두 마치겠습니다.
Thank you. This concludes the press conference given by President Moon and President Trump.